Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, January 19th, 2012. Well, it's a little after 8 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast, and we do have stock index futures above fair value, so we are looking for a higher open at 9:30 Thursday morning. I'm a little behind schedule this morning. My dog actually found a cat when we were out walking this morning at 5:30. It's a little kitten, and so we brought it home, and I guess first we're going to find out if somebody's reported it missing, but otherwise we might have a new member of the family. Well, yesterday was another positive day for the markets, and the VIX, while it had a lot of volatility intraday, it did close down and erase the gains of the previous day. So we still have the VIX for the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ 100 both on sell signals. That's positive for higher stock prices. The bonds reversed yesterday and actually put in a bearish reversal day. The bonds have been in a tight range for a long time now, and we're still looking for a breakout of that range. If it could take out the bottom at 140, that would certainly be positive for stocks going forward, and would certainly indicate that money is flowing out of the bond market and hopefully back into stocks. It doesn't necessarily mean it's going to go back into stocks, but there's not a lot of places for that much money to go that doesn't have the risk profile of, say, a commodity or a currency. Speaking of currencies, the U.S. dollar was down sharply yesterday, so we're looking for a close below 80.75 on Thursday to give us a sell signal, or above 128.90 to give us a buy signal for the euro, and the Canadian dollar is now back on a daily buy signal. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices. No changes for copper, gold, or silver yesterday. Crude oil was up nicely yesterday. We still have to close above $1.02 to give us a new buy signal on Thursday. Gasoline was up yesterday. Heating oil was down. It's now on a sell signal. And natural gas closed lower yesterday. It actually had an inside day, so less volatility than the previous day. And so traders are going to be looking for a breakout of Tuesday's range. Of course, a close above 229.30 would give us a buy signal. Don't expect to see that on Thursday. Looking at my five favorite stocks, Apple Computer made a new high for this move yesterday. That's bullish. No change for the CME Group. We're still on a sell signal. No change for Google. We're still on a sell signal. Goldman Sachs, as we mentioned yesterday morning, they reported and impressed investors. Had a nice update yesterday. Visa back on a buy signal and up testing previous highs. Let's take a look at the major indexes, and just a couple of changes yesterday. No change for the TSX. We're still on a buy signal. Energy stocks turned around. They're back on a buy signal, so you need to take a look at your ETFs and your stocks in the energy sector. No change for financial services. Gold stock still on a sell signal. Materials still on a buy signal. No change there. No change for metals and mining, and no change for the venture exchange. Looking at the U.S. indexes, a higher high for the S&P 500 yesterday. The NASDAQ 100 broke out to a new high for this move. So next test is 2437.50, and if we break out above that, then 2500 would be our next target. Looking at the bank stocks, for the most part, most of the U.S. bank stocks look like this, but there has been a lot of volatility in some of the majors over the last couple of days, like Citigroup and J.P. Morgan, which had a major turnaround yesterday and moved higher. So some of the big stocks are having troubles, but most of the what would be called regional banks are doing fairly well in the U.S. right now. Energy stocks, like similar to the Canadian market, reversed yesterday and now back on a buy signal. So not a lot of downward pressure with the price of oil reversing. Gold, the XAU, which is a gold and silver index, is still on a buy signal. If you look at any of the straight gold indexes like the gold bugs or the gold miners, they're having downward pressure, just like the Canadian TSX gold index. Silver stocks, whether you're looking at our index or the silver miners, are doing a little better. Certainly have not generated sell signals the way that we've seen in the gold sector. Fertilizer stocks doing very well right now. And we had a huge up move for the SOX index on Wednesday, and that is very bullish for the overall market. Taking a look at Thursday's roadmap using the 60-minute charts, see a nice head and shoulders pattern for the TSX. So people who watch that are going to be quite interested. There's your head. There's the left shoulder, the right shoulder. So you take that distance and you look up. And so our next target, of course, is 12,500. Take a look on the downside. We're going to remain bullish on the TSX on Thursday as long as we don't start closing below 12,273. Looking at the U.S. market, again, we continue to trade above the hourly flypaper channel, which is bullish. We are up, getting pretty close to the 13,1250 level. That's our next target to the upside. And it looks like that's where we're trading in the pre-market this morning. A breakout above that level should take us up to 13,2813. On the downside, the first sign of weakness on Thursday is going to be an hourly close below 12,9859. Okay, folks, that's all for Thursday morning. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.